Hello, everybody. Yes, of course, this is myself, David Harrington here. We'd like to welcome you back to episode 2 of my Let's Play series here on Coldborough Park Farm. What's in store for you on episode 2? Well, we're going harvesting a field. And let's hope that the Ford is going to draw all the green. So, we're in here on the farm now. And we have the Ford up. Just update you on the Ford. She got white tires and, of course, I got the old loader bracket, and she's still on the sexy trailer, as I call it. I have come up with another plan as well. I will be selling the baler, and also selling, where are we going around here now? Let me see. I'll be selling that as well. So I'll be selling the baler and that, which will bring more money. So as you can see, we have the harvester. She's all ready to rock and rumble. We took out a massive bank loan in episode 1 to pay for this. Let's hope she doesn't break down. So, inside the old Massey Ferguson combine now. The whole field, well, pretty much most of the field anyway, is fertilized, so the crop will be a bit better. So, what we're going to do here now is we're going to press the button on the G27 steering wheel. It's going to fire her up. So, we're going to let her warm up for now a couple of seconds. I'm going to press button number 5 on my Cytec control panel. That unfolds it. And so what we're going to do now is we're going to harvest this field, and we're going to sell the grain from it, and hopefully a bit of money comes in from it. So what we do here is we press number 4. That turns on the header, cruise control, and away we go. So we're going to leave out the swarts for it, and I'll probably bale it. It's some episode. What I'm trying to say to you here is basically I have a brand new Coon baler ordered, and that should be here in a couple of weeks, so that will bale out this field. Basically this episode 2 is to harvest this field, and we're harvesting wheat with a brand new combine. Clean delight with it. She's 9380. You've seen in episode 1 that I bought it. It cost a fair bit of money, but I know you're probably interested. Right, he has a Massey Ferguson combine, but he sold a Massey Ferguson tractor. But there was no need for a Massey Ferguson tractor when I had the Ford. See, I updated the Ford, as I told you there a few minutes ago. She'd be all good now. She'll have the front loader attachment. When we make enough money, I'll buy a bigger tractor, because we're going to need it, because this field is going to have to be ploughed out. All that kind of crack. So, episode 2 is harvesting this field, and we just hope a lot of money comes out of it for the grain. The prices aren't great at the moment, which, look, there's nothing you can do about that. They just don't want to give me a good price for it, but that's life, isn't it? Now, as you can see, the traffic is very busy here in Coldborough today, absolutely flat to the mat. There's so many fields around this place, I don't know what I'm going to do. Hopefully the farmers close by to me, they'll be able to give me a bit of work on them, so I can make a bit of extra cash, and you never know, they might drop down the price as well on the fields with the crop in it. And of course, this combine, then she's going to be doing a lot of work, plenty of it. So we're not around even halfway around the first headland there, but maybe we are gone above halfway. But look up there in the top left hand corner on the screen, 86%. So it's easy to know that this field was fertilised quite well by the Ford. And I don't know how long it's going to take me to fill the trailer, but yeah, she's nearly full. So I'm going to put out button number 10. That pops out the pipe for us. So maybe there will be a lot of grain from this field. So who knows, we might make a lot of money. She's getting near full there now. She will. There she is. So, the first full tank in a Massey Ferguson 9380. So, the Ford, she's ready to rock and rumble. Now she'll have no problem going down the field. Coming up the field could be a bit of a problem for her. But look, she'll do. As you can see there now, the front brackets are in it, and the white tires. Front loader attachment on as well. We'll just drive around the edge of the field, heading down to the combine. get the first load of grain. Not sure how many loads it's going to take to fill this trailer. Sure, I suppose we won't be long finding out. It's just a great day today. Look at all the clothes out in the line and everything. Great day for the harvest, isn't it? It's right. So, let's load her up. We'll have to turn off the old tractor now. Save the old diesel, because the old funds aren't the best at all. So, yeah. I'm quite happy with everything I have here. Like, so this is the only bit of gear I own, is that front weight, that tractor, that trailer, that combine, that header. But let's hope and pray that we get a bit of money anyway. Do you know what I mean? For the grain, because, you know, as farming these days, it's just tough enough. That's the God honest truth. It's just very tough. So we get ready to turn her on. Get ready to put her in cruise control and close the pipe. Pipe closed, cruise control on. Let's finish off the headland. So, yes, I'm quite delighted with this combine. You see, anyone that knows David Harrington, when he's playing Farm Simulator, I was mad for the New Holland combine. I don't know why. And then you see, I was on this other Let's Play series as well. You can check it out. Aberdeenshire, it's a live episode I do. I'm up to level 20 in it. Or episode 20, I should say. And one day, I was there. Right, no money one day. Right, I was like, right, what am I going to do? So I worked as hard as I could to get a combine. And lo and behold, no matter what game I'm going to be in now, this is the combine I'm going to use. I absolutely love this combine. Great, great workhorse. Of course, the case header fits on it. So, absolutely delighted. Now, as you can see there on the top left-hand corner, like we're filling up fairly lively. I mean, so, good crop on it. Very good crop, I'll say no. Very marvellous crop of wheat here. I just hope the prices are good. As you can see, lovely day here in Coalborough as well. And as I look outside my window here, where I'm recording this Let's Play as well, the sun is splitting the rocks. So, between the sun splitting the rocks outside in real life, and the sun splitting the rocks here in-game, look, everyone, it doesn't get much better than that. And updating my setup as well, I run a Logitech G27 wheel. I also run a Corsair keyboard, a Corsair mouse, Cytec control panel, and of course I run a desktop which has an i7 processor, iCore 7 processor. She recently, not so long ago, I installed a 3TB hard drive into it, because she was running low on space. And of course, I gave her something wrong there now. I gave her an SSD drive. Of course, that is to fire her on a lot quicker. Absolutely clean delight with it. Also, this computer has 16GB of RAM as well. And if you're all wondering what the graphics card is, it is a GTX 970. Of course, later on in the future, I will upgrade the graphics card, but for the moment, no need. She's doing exactly what she needs to do. And what I'm looking at here as well is two 24-inch monitors, Acer screens. And of course, the headset I'm using to do all these Let's Plays and talk on multiplayer and in TeamSpeak and everything is a Corsair headset. So we're on the second headland now of the field. As flat to the metal heads, I'm telling you, I'm absolutely delighted with it. And the tank is half full already. It won't be long before the old Ford is. Now, of course, I'm going to have to buy a lot of sheep and cows and pigs and all that good jazz, but it'll be a while because physically can't afford them at the moment. I'm hoping this harvest does a lot of work for me because, to be honest with you, you'll probably agree with me, I need a bigger tractor, but we're going to have to stick with the Ford. And never diss the Ford. So I say, A340, never diss it, because they're an amazing tractor, both in Farm Simulator, both in real life as well. Of course, you can see there now, the tank is nearly full. It'll be long filling this when the field is well fertilised. So that's all ready to rock and rumble. We should go get the Ford. Of course, the Ford is here. Turn her on. She's ready for road. What's in there at the moment? 27%. Went downhill, she'll fly like a medium. So, not load into the Ford now. Quite happy with it. No, I mean, you're going to see me, sick of me saying this, but I love the Ford. Simplest of facts. So, turn her off and back into the compact. You're going to say, Jesus, there's beacons on everywhere? There's, of course. Anyone that knows David Harrington loves beacons. Absolutely loves them. So, warm her up again. And just take it there now. Have to kind of square off the field as well, kind of way. Do you know the way the field is kind of built? It's just kind of awkward. So I'll go around the headland anyway. And might come straight down the field as well. No, square it up a bit because make it easier for the Coon Baylor when it comes. So button number 10 closes the pipe. Of course that is on the Cytec control panel. So it's a bit awkward here now. But look, when you're a talented driver like I am, it's all good. Well, that's what I say. For people to say, okay, but you can't drive at all. I can drive, but I've never driven a combine in real life now. Where I am, part of my world down here in County Kerry. You wouldn't see combines very often, not in South Kerry anyway. You know what I mean? So, as you can see there, second headland, still on it. Traffic still flat out. That field over there in front of me, that's Canola. We'll have to tip into that in a certain episode as well. Hopefully, the money is good. Because you can't pay that bit of money. Like, I'm going to buy a big tractor for blowing this field. And if you want to see my plow, go to my episodes on Lawford's and see what plow I have. She's a big puppy. She's going to need big horsepower to pull her up and down this hill. So, a lot of questions that come into me as well when I'm live streaming on our YouTube account. People will be asking me, what computer should I buy? And what steering wheel should I buy? And all that kind of crap. Now, I know one of my good old friends, Martin Aeroflá. You can check out his YouTube as well, Aero Gaming. He bought a Logitech G29 there about 2 weeks ago. €200 for a Logitech G29 in PC world. Now that offer is probably over and done with. But it's a great offer, everyone. If you got it, fair play to you, because I remember 2011 when I bought this Logitech G27 that I'm using. I bought this in 2011. It came in from Belgium for €350. But it hasn't caused me an ounce of trouble. It's part of my setup that you see all over Facebook. A big setup here, we'll put it that way. We're looking at €2,500-3,000 between everything that's in, between the computer, the keyboard, the mouse mat, the G27, the Cytec, the speakers, the headset, the screens. There's plenty more where that came from, do you know what I mean? So the setup is nowhere near finished yet, but for the moment, anyway, we're doing all these Let's Plays on this setup. You know what I mean? So you're probably saying, no, David, what do you ask? Well, I'm trying to straighten the field. If you catch my drift now, people will be saying, what the hell in the hell is he at? Well, I'm trying to make the field easier for myself. Maybe it works, maybe it doesn't. Sure. If it doesn't work, you know, you can let me know in the comments on YouTube. Or you can also check out the streams as well. On the old Facebook as well. Yes, Aero Agri Contractor Facebook page. So as I say, everyone, I was going to square off the field. And I think I haven't done a bad old job. Like I said, if you disagree, make sure you let it know in the comments. If I'm doing it wrong, if you want it done some other way, let me know. But you see, when you kind of square off the field and split it up, it makes the job so much faster. Like, this isn't a multiplayer, I'm all on my lonesome here inside in this field. Now, there will be a queer amount of bales out of it when the Coon Baylor comes. But the good thing about it is, I'll sell a lot of the bales. Saying, why the hell are you going to sell the bales, Dave? Why do you think? Need the money. And of course, the Ford is nearly folded as well. So, flat out, everyone. Flat out. See the Ford there now. Is she going to be able to take off from that hill? I don't know. But we'll soon find out once the trailer is full. So, we'll fill her up there now. Fill up the front of it. It's another thing I like in this game as well. There's another way you can go backwards and forwards. See the way she's filling up there now? It's going to her off here now. See? Yeah. roll down the hill. So it's a nice, even shape the whole way across the trailer. I see she's nearly full, everyone, is she? She is. Full, I think. So, what I'm going to do now, we'll start on this side of the field. And, won't be long to finish it. Now, I do see there's another corner there that we have to square off. So, we'll do that in a couple of minutes. And I'm going to go, just keep going straight down there now. Kind of even it off, angle it. Or, whatever. You know what I'm raving about here. You know me. I'm a raver, but people love to see me confused. And people also love for me to do something when I mess up. Like I did in episode 1. I saw through everything, I was thinking, oh man, what have I done? I got a bank loan. But look, let's see how long it takes before I lose my mind with this game. But you know, it could happen, it might happen. Only time will tell. But also in this episode, once we've disharvested, we're selling that round baler, selling that front part of the sprayer as well, to make more cash. Yes, it's very easy to press Control, Alt, and Zero and get loads of money. Why would I? That's not what Farm Simulator is about. Farm Simulator is about working to get big machines, feed your cows, feed your pigs, feed your hens, so on and so forth. You gotta work hard at it. Yes, I have a bankroll taken out. That's what you do in real life. The only way you know you'd have a massive farm is if you won the lotto. And lads, I done the lotto for Friday night. I never won it. So, what I'm at here at the minute now is I am just doing this little part here, right? Small little rows, but look, you know yourself, you run. It all counts. It all counts. We're always going to rake it in later on in life and fix that up a bit. But show you the field there now. I mean, so going through it nicely. It doesn't take long when you're on your own. So, on to the last bit of the field. These are going to be very long rows, and so we have one trailer load of grain out of it now. So we're going to sell one trailer anyway. See what the money's like. And then following that day, the money's not great. Let's store it for a later date. So everybody, the combine is full. The trailer is full. Let's see how long it takes to get this down to where we're going. We'll actually find out where we're going. Let me see now. We'll go back here. We're at wheat. Biogas plant it is. Not a far old journey. So as you can see, she's struggling a small bit. Rolling hill start. Now she's flat a bit. So not much of the field left. So the next trailer load will be stored. Let's see, Jesus Chris. We're bouncing around the place. Now hopefully now the old traffic isn't bad. Traffic is bad. Let's just stop. We've kind of a rolling hill start. No traffic coming. Shoot to the floor. Ooh, drifting. Oh, out of that. People say you can't drift a tractor. But I tell you this much. David Capey can. So everyone, just kind of a slow trip to the BGA. But even Gold Cab now, you'll see what I mean. I mean, she's. I had the shoe to the floor. Not going too bad. Oh, we're holding up the traffic. Now, as you can see up there in the top right-hand corner, we have 18,178. The question is, what are we going to have at the end with this trailer? Let's see. Is wheat doing good? The feed there? No, I don't know. Do I own that? She says, I own that to be a great boost, isn't it? So we'll see. No passage here now. Is there kind of a little for sale sign here? Doesn't look like it. Maybe I do own that field, I don't know. I know I don't own the grass field there. But we get it. Right, so everybody, we're at the BGA. I don't know what goes up there. Never been up that road. Maybe there's nothing up there, I don't know. But yeah. Right, into the BGA. Over the ramp. Oh, jeez. That was scary. Very scary. So what's the money? See, I've up to 30,000. So I'll see what I get for the trailer load if it comes up on the screen for me. 32,000. Do you know something? I am absolutely delighted with that. 32,000? Now that is a good price for that trailer. Well, look, it makes my bank balance look a small bit better. So what I'm going to do, lads and ladies, head back to the farm and load that combine because she's mad for work. So, nearly back at the field now. Bank balance is looking good. 50,000. Now, what is David going to do with 50,000? Well, after I finish harvesting the field, you see, in this episode as well, I'm going to sell the baler and all that good jazz, and I'll be a nice person, lads. I'll pay back some of the bank note. So, it depends on what comes, how much this trailer is now. That's not good there now, is it? So, once we fill this trailer, see what she has after this load of the combine, and if it's nearly full, we'll go down again. That'll be another 30,000, that'll be 60,000. That won't be bad, will it? Not bad at all. Tractor needs an oil wash too. Trailer, not so much. She's good. Trailer is working very well with that tractor. It's a Massey Ferguson MF Delta 9380. That is the combine. Let me know in the comments, everyone. Are you a fan of this Massey Ferguson combine? Because I certainly am. So, we're at the end of the field, everyone. Well, close enough to it. I do hope that you're enjoying these episodes anyway. Of course, this is only episode 2. Make sure that you've checked out episode 1. Make sure you hit it a like. And make sure you subscribe for more of these great videos. There's so many more different types of videos going to be coming up on this YouTube channel. But for the moment now, we're on episode 2 here on Coldwell Park Farm. On a big harvest. Of course, we bought this combine yesterday to go to massive bank loan. Yep. To be honest, where would you be without a bank and farmers and litter? We lost. Absolutely lost. And I have to upgrade the tractor, alright. She is struggling. But look, it was my own mistake in selling the other tractors. I should have driven down and bought more money or something like that. Look, this is all part of the Let's Play series with David Harrington. Is always show the funny side and the awkward side. And like other people, they probably cut out all the wrongs, the rights, all that kind of jazz. And I record, and whenever I record, it goes into the video. Simple as that. So, let me know your takes on this anyway. Like, to be honest, like, I love this car. I absolutely love it. Do you know what? I'm going cap for a minute now. Like, you know, right, there's a case header on her, but she's probably had no bother in the world. Not a bother in the world. Now, next trailer load, right? Depends what's in it. Am I going to go to the BGA or am I going to store it? Do you know what I mean? I'm going to have so much more to harvest anyway throughout the Let's Plays. Go down. Get it there, lads. Yeah. This is a very big field. Of course, this is field number 9. So, field we're in. And I do hear the lads of Air Ag right there, they have their own save game in this. Just a couple of the lads from the Air Ag team, they were telling me, field number 9, I don't like it. They have to keep replowing it and replanting it a whole lot. Sure, there's 4 or 5 of them. There's only one of me. For sure, look. I'm a carryman. We're as tough as nails down this part of the world. So I've harvested out this field. Delighted to have it finished. Over to the combine now. Or should I say, over to the trailer. What we'll do then is we unload what we have in it. 33%. Not a lot, is it? It's not a lot. So, first back in now, the trailer's kind of left awkward by me. You'd have that. So, just trying to see now. Just trying to think, what do I do? Do I sell the grains in the trailer, or do I store it? But I know first things first. I'm going to have to bring the combine back to the farm and store her there. So that's what we're going to do right about now. She's all loaded, folded up, ready to go back to the farm. Probably the next field to be done is one there to the right. has to be fertilised and all that good jazz. But for the moment now, we're just going to bring this back to the farm. Turn off the electric heater here behind me because it's hot and cold, everyone. It really is. I'm up into the yard here now. Get a lift. And we'll plank the combine. So, the trailer is half full. So, still deciding what do I do. Do I store it? Do I sell it? We'll store it. Right. This is going to be very interesting to watch, lads. This is the Ford. I'm going to try and climb this hill. Now, since Bullet Bill fixed this map, he's done something with the gravity in it, which I absolutely love. Of course, Owen Walsh, he's a manager here on our Air Agri team as well, and his T7 struggles even on this hill. So you can see the mileage there now, what she's doing. She's had 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10. Now she's only half full. Down to 9 kilometers per hour. We go, Kev. Will she make it up, lads and ladies? Will she make it up? It'll take her a while. But it's like this. You never diss an older tractor. They've gone through rougher times than this. She will make it up there. It's just going to take an extra couple of seconds. And so we're en route now to the farm to store all this. There's 50% of wheat in the trailer. We're down to 6 kilometers. 7, she's climbing. You can hear the engine ticking over. She's getting harder, stronger. No bother for her. These are the only two bits of gear here. These couple of things are right beside each other. Very small farm at the moment, but we will be expanding. Don't worry about that. Hit the wall with the front weight. God, there was a weight on this place. We smashed the place. So, back her in. Seen in episode 1, I was selling stuff out here. Episode 2. Although, what I could do actually, now that I'm in here, hold on. Now that I'm in here, I'm stoked. Yes. We'll get there in time. So, unload this back into the tanks. God, we're not making enough money on it. Well, we are making plenty of money on it. But, no good for me. So, all that's unloaded. Time to sell the sprayer and the baler. Everyone, the Amazon FT101 being sold, and also the New Holland baler, because I said it to the crowd, I said I'd be down there now earlier on, later on today, and they were like, yeah, no problem, we're down, we'll give you the best price possible for that baler. There's a lot of people like the New Holland baler, but see, I'm moving from New Holland and with my equipment wise to Coole. A lot of gear ordered for the 14th of February. Looking forward to getting my hands on all of that. So on episode 2 so far, everyone, harvested field 9 with wheat. We sold one trailer worth of wheat at 32,000 for it. Another trailer there now stored at the farm. We'll have to store it until the price gets better. So all I have to do is sell the front attachment on this tractor and the baler. And let's hope a good bit of money comes into it. I'll go to the indicator. I don't know we're here, but I beat the horn. We are here, peeps. So, what we'll do, we will jump off the baler first and do this. So we get out. So the baler there now, what is the price for the baler? Let's see. Drive over here now and see what they're offering. So we just pressed. R. 51,000. So 51,000 for Baylor. Not bad. Not bad at all. What are we going to get for this? Let's see. So we go in here. 4,000. It's not a lot of money. I've no need for it. So bang. But look. That's that done. We have 107,000 now in the bank. What can we do with that? We'll keep it for another while, everyone. I was gonna pay off the bank loan, but we'll keep building up the money. And the bank loan will be taken out over time. So, I'm on my way back to the farm to hook way back up in front of this. And of course, go to you on a trip. That is it, everyone, for episode 2. I do hope you have enjoyed. And so episode 2 consists of harvesting that weed there on field number 9. And of course, not to forget, selling a load as well. So all that's left for me to do is back up this trailer and say to you, thanks for watching. Make sure you like and subscribe. Episode 3 coming to your screens very soon. Myself, David Harrington, thanks a million for taking this time out of your busy lifestyle watching episode 2 of myself, David Harrington, here on Coldborough, Ireland. Until next time.